Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking today about finding the equation of a line. And for some students that have recently come from like a pre-algebra class or a basic algebra class, this is the first topic where they really start to struggle because it's not in the previous class. Finding the equation of a line is sort of a new concept, so keep your mind open. We can find an equation of a line in different formats, but we're going to be finding the equation of a line in slope-intercept form, and that is y equals mx plus b. And we've already done a little bit of this from a picture we found in that, but now we're going to be doing it from given information, and we have to then figure out what that slope is. So when I write these ordered pairs as ordered pairs, you can see that the first ordered pair is the y-intercept. The y-intercept is when x is 0. So if I was going to write this, I already know almost everything I need. I know the y-intercept is 9. What I don't know is what the slope is. So you have a couple of choices here. One, you could do the math of the slope formula, which we saw in another video. We don't do a ton of it in this class, but we can, if we wanted, plug in and find it that way. But look what's happening here. As we go up by 1 for the x, so if I change by 1, what's the change for the y? Well, the change in y is 2. For every 1x, I go up by 2. So my slope would actually look like I rise 2 for every 1x, because the y, or the rise, is the y, which is on the top. So I can see from this that I'm going up by 2 for every 1. So that's my slope, is 2. If you wanted to, though, you could plug that in. You could say I have 11 minus 9 on the top, and I have 1 minus 0 on the bottom. And then you could see that's 2 over 1 and go, oh, yeah, that's right. But you can also see it just by looking at the pattern. Oh, that's supposed to be 13, and that's supposed to be 13. That does not work with a 3 there. Okay, sorry. That's just me being careless when I wrote that down. Okay, so we can see the pattern of 9 to 11 to 13, 0, 1, and 2. There's my equation. This is what they're looking for. That's the equation of a line in slope-intercept form. What if they give you the slope and the intercept? Notice that the slope can be given as m, because we can always abbreviate slope with m, and the y-intercept could be given as b. It's never given as y, because we don't abbreviate y-intercept with y. Or we could just give it as an ordered pair, like we saw up here. We have to know y-intercept is what we get when x is 0. Remember always what I'm trying to do here is take this equation and replace the b and replace the m with numbers. So here they give me everything I need. My m is 1/3 and my b is 4. If I don't see a sign, I assume that's positive, and I'm just going to write plus 4. Now, they don't have to give it to me in that order. They could flip-flop the order, but b is always at the end, and the m is always the coefficient of the x. Okay, you should do the other two quickly. You could probably get ahead of me here while I write down y equals. Doesn't take long to do these if you recognize what you have. What you have here is slope is negative 2. That's the coefficient of the x, and the y-intercept is 5. Here, b is 1/2. That's the y-intercept. That goes at the end. It doesn't matter what order they give those to you. It still has to go at the end. Here, our slope is negative 3/4, and our y-intercept is 1/2. So if they give you the slope and the y-intercept, you just plug that directly into the formula. Not bad, right? And the last thing is just an application of a word problem. They're saying the fixed cost of owning a warehouse is $3,250 per month. Maybe that's the lease payment. And the owner also pays $175 per day for utilities. Find an equation in slope-intercept form describing the owner's monthly cost. Let's take a second to remember this. The y-intercept is b, and that is the initial, in this case, the initial cost, or we can say the fixed cost, right? That's what, even if we didn't turn the heat on, we still have to pay this cost of owning the warehouse. This is the change that goes on day by day. Slope is a rate of change, and that is $175 per day. So, in this case, the slope is 175. We can call days, let's say, D or X. And the initial cost is, or the starting cost is $3,250. So, let me go back and call that X. I don't know why randomly I just threw another variable in there. But what I want you to see is that if X was zero, that is if no days have passed, you've paid $3,250. After one day, you're going to pay this and then 175 times one or one more. So if it said it, what, you know, what if he owned the warehouse and didn't and no days had passed? Well, that would be initial cost of this. What does it cost him in addition for when one day passed? Well, it additionally cost him $175 for each day that passed. All right, so you have a couple of questions about this kind of a thing on your homework. I think you'll find it doable once you get there. Have a fantastic day.